Like other GMP tools, DV360 operates on a hierarchy. DV360's hierarchy looks like this. At the top of the hierarchy are partners, which represent agencies, trading desks, or large individual marketers. Next is the advertiser, which represents real-life businesses that run advertising campaigns. Often, there are multiple advertisers nested beneath a partner. If you're an agency, you'll build advertisers for your clients. If you're a direct marketer, the advertisers will represent your brands. If you're a publisher, this level will represent your brands, your advertising brands, your agency clients, or any combination based on your structure. Beneath the advertiser level, we have campaigns, which house all insertion orders and line items for a particular media plan, grouping them all towards a common goal or strategy. Next, we have insertion orders, or IOs. IOs contain a set of line items that are related to the same advertising campaign. Each insertion order has its own budget rolling up to an overall campaign budget. The insertion order level is really where your budget first comes into play, and IOs must be added for any budget to deliver. Depending on your strategy and technical requirements, you'll have the ability to set up some default line item targeting, like frequency caps and geo-targeting, at the campaign or IO level. At the bottom of the hierarchy, we have line items. These bid on impressions and serve creatives to inventory sources based on their parent insertion order. Line items define the most granular details, the who, what, and where, of your ad targeting. Now let's take a look at the DV360 user interface. We log into the partner level of DV360, as we can see at the top of my page. I'm logged in as Adswerve. As you click through different areas of DV360, you'll be able to tell what hierarchy level you're in based on the breadcrumbs at the top of the page. For example, if I click into an advertiser, then a campaign, the breadcrumbs will show me how my current location relates back to the advertiser or partner. When we log into our account and navigate to an advertiser, we land on the Campaigns tab, where we can see all the campaigns we currently have trafficked. From this tab, we can create, optimize, and monitor campaigns, line items, and insertion orders. Continuing down the left panel, we have the Audiences tab, where we can view and manage audiences in DV360. Next in the left panel, we have the Creative tab. This serves as our creative library and houses all creatives uploaded into DV360, as well as those ported over from other linked tools like CM360. The Inventory tab helps us discover and manage high-quality inventory from top broadcasters and publishers, including exploring new opportunities in marketplace and negotiating deals. In the Reporting tab, we get all of the campaign metrics we need. We can use features that help us analyze performance across display and video 360 and take action on those results. Now let's skip down a bit and touch briefly on advertiser settings. The sections nested within this tab are where you can manage all the settings for the advertiser you're currently logged into. Finally, the History tab is a change log that shows all changes across the account. This area is helpful when multiple people are working in the campaign or within the account, and we need to be aware of who's doing what. This area can also show you how changes are impacting your campaign. If this left panel ever gets in the way, we can collapse it by clicking the pancake stack above the panel. Clicking that stack again will expand the left panel. Now let's shift our focus to the toolbar on the top right of the page. Starting at the far right, we have our user profile. Below our user profile, we see a question mark icon, which is the DV360 Help Center. This is a great resource regardless of your skill level, but especially if you're new, as you can easily search article resources. To the left of our profile is the GMP Launchpad icon, where we can switch between the different GMP products that we have access to. For example, if we're linked with CM360, this is where we can navigate to Reporting and Attribution to get a more holistic view of our data. You can easily navigate between products by clicking on the one you'd like to switch to. Note that your GMP Launchpad may look different than mine depending on which tools you have access to. Next, we have keyboard shortcuts. This shows us hotkeys that might help us work more efficiently in DV360. Then we have the Reports icon, where we go to build new DV360 reports and see all of our existing ones. Please note, this is only for DV360-specific reporting. If you're linking to CM360 and are looking for more holistic and robust reporting, that would be accessed via CM360 reporting and attribution once you have both platforms linked. To the left of that, we have the bulk status icon. This area shows the edit history for all bulk actions in DV360. Next, we have the user management and email preferences icon. Here, we can add, remove, and edit users if we have the appropriate permissions. We can adjust email preferences for the partner and advertisers, and we can view Google-provided updates and offers. The bell to the left of user management displays notifications related to our account. Finally, the magnifying glass icon opens a search bar we can use to quickly find specific items in DV360.